Perfect. Awesome. Sometimes it's good and sometimes it's terrible. Ready to do this? Okay. Hey guys, welcome to The Disruptors, the podcast where we get, quite literally, the folks that are disrupting the future and the way we think about it on. Today we've got one of them, Glenn Loury. Thanks for coming today, Glenn. And it's good to have you on as well. I wanted to get you on. You first came to my attention from the intellectual dark web guys, and I wanted to dive into that movement a little bit in terms of the smaller scale public intellectual that suddenly becomes mainstream. Take me through your story a little bit and how you became associated with those guys. They got you listed on the website, so I think there might be something in the works. But in terms of why I wanted to have you on, I think that contrarian view is incredibly important. I imagine, although I'm not sure, is this because, do you think you're like that because your economist type mind, you're able to think about things logically as opposed to emotionally? Well, it comes down to empathy. If you're overly empathetic, you're only able to feel something. You're not able to rationally think about it. I think that's a big part of the problem that we have in society today is people feel things, but they're not willing to think or reason. Let's get into affirmative action. I know that's a big ticket item for you. How How do we deal with that going forward? Because I mean, you're a professor now at Harvard. Harvard had their fair share of scandals when it comes to affirmative action and Asian students. How can we think about this? And do you think we should have affirmative action, not have affirmative action? Break down your opinions and your thoughts on the matter, because you're much more educated than most on this.
Thank you.
No, it's good. And it creates a major problem, not just from the equality perspective, but also from a jealousy type perspective. Essentially, it creates emphasis on race where we want to be eliminating the emphasis on race because it shows us how we're different. And it points out differences among us that create more problems than they solve. And let's look forward 50 years. The technology that's coming right now in terms of self-augmentation combined with what we're learning more and more about health. You see the top echelons of society living longer and longer, and you see the lower economic classes having shorter and shorter lives. You see relatively the same thing happening when it comes to intelligence and IQ. And then with CRISPR genetic engineering and the world we're moving towards, how do we avoid having a world where people are incredibly different? Wealth access. So if you look at the richest portions of society, I think I haven't looked at the stats, but based off of the stats I've seen in the past, I would imagine that the lower income is typically more correlated with being African. Actually, before we jump into that, I've always found the term African American to be incredibly derogatory. I think black is a better term because why would you have to have an adjective qualifier on the fact of being an American? That's just a quick side note. What are your thoughts? Okay, let's hear it.
Respectable.
If you don't get rid of the history, you can never have a better future. It's really interesting, especially the fact that you can see someone, and if you know one or two things about them, you can predict almost all of their political beliefs. It's dangerous. How do we deal with that going forward in a world that is so much more politicized, especially at the U.S. is very much an example of this. Ooh. With Trump's fake wig. There's two sides to the mob. Science has become so politicized lately. The one thing that's not supposed to be political is becoming toxic on both sides. How do you think about that and how we can change potentially that, especially with race, with climate change, with gender? There's also infinite funding for research looking the other way. You have all of big oil, all of coal, all of the right wing looking for any type of excuse they can find. It's absurd that people believe the Earth is flat. Does that include the repatriation of wealth? Because that's the major, major positive force, is that Trump let all of the tech companies bring back like $600 billion from Europe. Yeah, it's raining outside. If I'm an optimist, then yes, I can go outside and I don't need to shower. If I'm a pessimist, shit, I can't go to the park. How you think about the world affects your well-being and also affects how you interpret the world. It's definitely a major problem. I think the budget stuff is problematic because of the science behind it. I think the assumption that giving companies more money will lead to more jobs is being proven false because companies are worried about the future. it feels like we're at a peak right now where there's going to be a crash coming in the not too distant term. I know my background is looking at businesses and trends, and 60 to 80% of public market CEOs say they would rather forego long-term guaranteed profitable investment than have the books look better now so they get their bonuses. And it's because they're worried about the future and the bonuses are short-term focused. I think that short-term bias is really problematic with society. How do you think about the justice system? So we talked about single parent households. That's incredibly common, unfortunately, with African Americans, especially being incarcerated for having marijuana, which is now legal in a lot of states. Just really your thoughts on the broken incentives, the system of prisons. You covered a bit of it. Yeah, imagine if you had police officers ticketing you for going 1 mile an hour over. If you incentivized them to write tickets, that's what happens. Oh. Eventually, you get to the gulag system like USSR. What technology are you most excited about that's upcoming? What are you worried about then? Perfect. At least if we're going to have it, you might as well get your deal. Do you It definitely is. I think with I definitely agree with Yuval, but at the same time, for him to sell books, it's not exactly exciting if you say everything's going to be rosy and good and easy and not that different than today. But I'm very much of his opinion in terms of where we're headed. I think it's problematic. Glenn, I got one last question for you, and that is we brought up automation a little bit. What are your thoughts on the future of the economy in terms of a UBI or some other type of system if automation really comes quickly, and we're having issues dealing with it. If I gave you $5 million and banned you from working for the rest of your life, what would you do? Banned you from working for an employer for the rest of your life. You can still do what you want. You can still run the podcast, have interesting conversations, write papers, but you don't have to. Oh, do what? Yeah, you could still do that. I don't see why not. I don't see why not. It's not a job. You are, but make sure you're not doing any solo ones that could be questionable. Okay, so it sounds like it at least could possibly be interesting. Glenn, I've had you on here for a while. I want to thank you for coming on. One last thing. What would you leave people with? Quote, call to action, etc. Spontaneous, you always get the real answers. Read books, spoken like a true professor. I like, or a true, I like it. I like it. Read books. Someone else has had your problem before. Glenn, where's the best place? Exactly. That's a good place to close. Glenn, where can people find you? And we'll have links and everything in the show notes, guys. Glenn with two N's. Thanks for coming on today, Glenn. Sweet. Cheers. And disruptors.fm if you guys like this, remember to subscribe. Cheers. Awesome. That was good. That is a wrap. Anything I can be helpful.